Okay, here's the announcement. You could have any political bias, but judge this conversation on the merit of this conversation. And you might hate me or the Congress party from before, but don't get that hate on now. Now judge this conversation for this and react however y'all are feeling.
Hey, shut up, yeah, Kunal.
Shut up, yeah, Kunal.
Hello people, welcome to another episode of Shut Up Ya Kunal. That's my podcast. Today with me is the national spokesperson of the Congress party, Priyanka Chaturvedi.
Hello Kunal.
Hello Priyanka, say hello to
hello
people
hello
in
everyone.
The people in the audience plus people on YouTube watching.
Yes,
hopefully.
So, yes, positively watching and positively
engaging.
Going to comment on it. So yes,
no,
hello to them as well.
No, commenters are never positive. When was the last time? See, I'll ask you a question. When was the last time you liked a restaurant and then you went and commented saying, "I love this restaurant," and it was so. It's always when the dal is fucked up. This dal fucked my life up. And there's so much hate. 1.5 paragraph about dal I read the other day on Zomato.
No. So I do comment very positively. I remember taking a flight for a SpiceJet flight and they had some awesome music playing.
Right.
I remember tweeting to them and saying, "You all had some awesome music playing on board." So
oh,
I do
nice.
That.
I never.
I'm kind of a nice person. So
yeah, positive. That way I'm just. I don't ever inflict any positive vibes on any airline because the moment you do, then they start fucking up.
And they face the chappals, alright.
I am wearing slippers today because I have a flight to catch.
सांसद हैं ये औरंगाबाद से चुनकर आए हैं इन्होंने एयर इंडिया के स्टाफ को प्लेन के अंदर चप्पल मारी है चप्पल के बारे में उन्होंने बाद में ये खुलासा किया है कि दरअसल चप्पल नहीं सैंडल मारी है
आपने 17 बार मारा उस आदमी को
किसको
चप्पल से उठा के
तो
आपने 17 बार मारा
से फेंक रहा था नीचे
आप उस आदमी को ऊपर से फेंक रहे थे
फेंक रहे थे
आप मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट है गायकवाड़ जी
यस
आपने 17 बार मारा उस आदमी को
यस
आप मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट है गायकवाड़ जी
यस
But yeah, today you're with me and I've, before we start with like Congress questions, you had a job before you joined the Congress party and it was a cool job. Apparently, I did some research. You worked at Channel V.
Yes, so I was with them and I'm sure in hindsight, they all feel who is this awkward chick who is working with them
right.
and is now a national spokesperson of a political party because I somehow, while I was working there, I had a great time and it was a good time that I spent there. Mm. Once I had a baby, I also moved to Calcutta because my
right.
husband got transferred there.
Oh, okay.
I started my own business after that because motherhood was a full-time job for me.
Right.
But somewhere down the line, again, I felt I was stagnating, I wasn't growing. And I think for me, since I'm a Mumbaiker, 2611 kind of changed my entire perspective to life and I realized that there was so much more I could contribute. I started in a very little, small way. Where
right.
I reached out to victims of 2611 attacks through various online bloggers who got
right.
together. We got on ground and we helped a couple of victims. So that is how it kept moving. But
right.
My true calling was communication. I felt I could, at that point of time, you would remember,
right.
at the fag end of our UPA tenure,
yeah.
communication wasn't really a strong point.
Pradhan Mantri ji ne BJP ko mukhatib karke ek sher padha. Unhone kaha. हमको उनसे वफा की है उम्मीद जो नहीं जानते वफा क्या है अध्यक्ष जी आप जानती हैं शायरी का एक अदब होता है शेर का कभी उधार नहीं रखा जाता इसलिए मैं प्रधानमंत्री का ये उधार चुकता करना चाहती हूँ एक नहीं दो शेर पढ़ के पहला
फिर उन पे उधार हो जाएगा
पहला प्रधानमंत्री जी कुछ तो मजबूरियाँ रही होंगी यूं ही कोई बेवफा नहीं होता और मजबूरी क्या है हमारी मजबूरी यह है कि आप इस देश के साथ बेवफाई कर रहे हैं इसलिए हम आपके प्रति वफादार नहीं रह सकते और मुल्क के साथ बेवफाई करने के लिए दूसरा शेर पढ़ रही हूं आपको मुखातिब करके तुम्हें वफा याद नहीं हमें जफा याद नहीं जिंदगी और मौत के दो ही तो तराने हैं एक तुम्हें याद नहीं एक हमें याद
So
they needed someone to communicate better.
So no, I thought my strength was communication and I was right. like, we must, connect the two.
Yeah.
So I did whatever I could through social media. The party realized that I was doing my bit on social media and they made me an official representative of a party at a time when nobody wanted to hear my party. So
yeah, currently I think you have a more tough job than the spokesperson for tobacco. You do, like, you do. I mean, it's a tough job. I'm not saying that you're advocating something wrong, but I'm just saying the job's bloody tough. Like, you can't go to a room full of haters and be like, here, guys.
No, now I'm sure everyone's listening to me nicely and they're all good to me. And
yeah.
They would realize that we are nice people too.
Of course they would, because this is Bombay. Go for banning something.
Yeah, that's what
yeah,
I
collectively,
guess.
If 30 million people are like, don't serve this, and I'll vote for you, I'll be like, yeah, of course, let's not serve it.
Yeah, I mean, why should we care for the rest?
Yeah.
It gets me the votes.
Yeah, 30 million.
No, but we won't do that. Just to clarify.
Yeah, I think this whole conversation, nobody's taking it as face value. There's a comedian talking to
no,
a
no, I'm
person.
Very seriously saying that.
Yeah.
So.
But it's great because you're also, you spoke about motherhood a little. You have two kids, I know that, because I visited you to convince you to be on the podcast, which you did. So please, that deserves a round of applause. My own mother didn't speak to me for 3 days after I put the video out. So Congress spokesperson, I'm really happy.
You know, I think we're used to that. No one wanting to watch us at a particular point in time.
So, it was great. So, you spoke a little bit about, you know, if your kids, like, just when they grow up, they want to pursue politics, what would your reaction be?
So, as of now, I've told them to concentrate on getting an education for themselves.
Right.
And if politics happens to be their calling, it was never their mother's calling initially. It
yeah.
happens to be their calling.
Right.
Then I think it is an opportunity I wouldn't want them to miss.
That's true. And for now, education is key.
Absolutely.
Even if they want to get into politics later, because Kejriwal will ask for your degree.
No, but I
there's no chance
that,
that you
is,
would get
that's,
educated.
That's a huge assumption that he's going to be around till then. So, huge.
Fuck off, guys. Let me tell you, I don't think Kejriwal will be around till then. He'll join Wipro or something. So let's not take this.
No, seriously. We must all help him get a job, right?
Yeah. Congress party. Cultivating jobs for Kejriwal.
Come on, he keeps flaunting his degree, so
yeah.
might as well use
might
it for
well.
A better cause.
I think he could get more foreign funding.
Paise ki kami nahi hone dunga.
No, our Prime Minister is great in getting foreign funding.
Aap to roj hi khade hoke Modi ji ka naam le dete ho. Isme Modi ji thodi kara rahe hain.
Let's not deny it. Jitne deshon mein jaake wo tabla baja ke aaye hain, sab deshon se check aa gaya, theek hai? Main bata raha hu, I'm sure. Don't look at things in a bad light, okay? She's wearing orange pants today just because.
Yo. So that we end up getting more votes. No, no, but I must say this. So that is because, you know, when I was going through a magazine, the magazine told me orange is the new black these days. So. So let's be very diplomatic about it.
But no, how are you feeling right now? Last 3 months have been great. Arnab Goswami has not been in your life.
No, so much before these 3 months, Arnab Goswami was not a part of the Congress spokesperson's life because we had chosen to kind of withdraw ourselves
from
that
show. And he used
yeah.
to keep an empty chair and put a
every
Congress.
Every time. I mean, I love the way he did that.
And every time he went to it also. The
I
Congress
that.
Party.
He missed us every time and he assigned an empty chair for us. So it was nice.
But two choices for picture of the day on the news are. Choice number one is on your screen. I need to say nothing, viewers. Take a long, hard look at this picture. Is this the picture of the day? That's choice one. Competing with this.
Is Sajjan ko kya takleef hai bhai? Kya takleef hai inko?
But here's the question. But Rahul's.
Yeah, sorry.
Do you think if he was born in another family, would he still be so politically aligned? Is
yeah,
it a coincidence that he was born in this family? Like, does it have no...
Do I have a choice? I'm born into a Chaturvedi family and I didn't have a choice, right?
No,
and,
no, but Chaturvedi family, you were born in, you know, people are like corporators, IAS officers. But you chose to pick up a guitar.
Hmm.
Right? So I'm like, oh, ye banda Jim Morrison banna chahta hai. Toh kya hua, iska father IAS officer hai. पर अगर मेरा सब फैमिली में 3 PM है और मैं भी PM बनना चाहता हूँ तो थोड़ा इधर ऐसा नहीं लग रहा है कि ये थोड़ा प्लान्ड है little bit like
नहीं I mean this is a charge which I'm sure if my son chooses to take up politics in his
he'll
life or my daughter
yeah
or my daughter who I think is more inclined to something like this But if she does, she's going to face questions the brunt like of this. It and she I don't think this hate will also continue or this whatever you wish to call it.
It's not hate. It's just that people already have an opinion about him and it's not changing anytime soon is what's coming across now.
Maybe now.
From the internet, from the questions that came to the both of us.
So you, the social media is dominated extremely by one set of people. And I wouldn't want to challenge that, but I would love to engage and answer those questions. Sure. However, I would say that what you hear on social media or what you speak on social media does not necessarily become the larger public opinion in the country.
Right. So, here are another few questions.
Can you see those questions?
No, not at all. This is my Panama Papers. Nobody can see it. The government has to ignore it. Any BJP scams you think don't get highlighted enough? Just by virtue of being BJP scams?
So...
see, if you say Vyapam, we'll have to disappear.
Maza aaya.
If Robert Wadra was not married into the Gandhi family, would he be as big an entrepreneur as he is? Is
I'm
it
sure.
all? I'm not saying there's a connection there. Hmm. Maybe there's no. We're just trying to join invisible dots. But this guy, if he was independent, like if he was my father's son, chemist shop and my, like whatever, would he be that big an entrepreneur?
I'm very certain he would, simply because he was already a very successful entrepreneur before he got married to Mrs. Gandhi,
right.
To Priyanka Gandhi.
Right.
So he was already extremely successful. His father had one of the biggest export firms in Delhi at that point in time.
Right.
It was one of the biggest export houses in Uttar Pradesh. They employed loads and loads of people and they continue working there. So he comes from a business which was already pretty successful.
Right.
So crediting that to
the Congress
those
party.
Invisible dots...
Yeah.
Doesn't
yeah, you're right. Nothing's
him.
Been proven. And but here's the actual question. If Sonia Gandhi wouldn't help her own son-in-law, then the people of the country are just thinking, would she really help us? please behave yourself. You all are not in parliament.
So here's how I'd answer this. So yeah. When we get elected into positions, we don't elect ourselves to help our family members.
Right.
We help ourselves to be able to be in a position which can help the country at large. So if you grudge someone for not helping their family members, or then you must also grudge Narendra Modi ji for leaving his family behind and working for this country.
Right.
Then you must grudge various other people, perhaps Yogi Adityanath, for not getting married and not having a family. I mean, where would your grudge stop? So, if you have chosen an elected position, you are in that position of strength. And if you choose to use it for helping the people and perhaps not helping your immediate family members,
right.
I think that should be appreciable, not laughed at.
Yeah. But I have a few other questions
sure.
about Robert, I hope.
Yeah,
Robert
yeah, sure.
Wadra,
sure.
I hope you don't mind answering that.
No, I won't.
What's his workout regime? Like he's totally...
That's something even I want to know. So perhaps when I meet him, I'm going to ask because he's extremely fit and...
But why would he...
I'm like struggling every day in the gym to lose like 3-4 inches of fat that I've gathered over the years. So yeah.
What is workout regime and like this netted t-shirt, no 40-year-old in India pulls it off, but he does it very well.
So that
like,
credit goes
when
to
when I see an article online, it's like how to lose belly fat. I'm just like, has Robert Wadra written it? Otherwise, I don't want to read it. Like, I would love to meet Robert Wadra and just discuss bench press workout.
Sure.
Because as you know, chest size is very important in this country.
In this country these days, yeah. Everything is 56 inch.
Every time we do we should do the Congress symbol and high five every time we crack a Modi joke.
राजनीति में 56 इंच का सीना बहुत अहम है अब प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी के सीने का असली साइज हिंदुस्तान को पता चला है जो 56 इंच नहीं बल्कि 50 इंच का है ये आगे बढ़े उससे पहले जरा आपको बताते हैं कि प्रधानमंत्री मोदी का सीना सलमान खान से भी 4 इंच चौड़ा है और तो और क्रिकेटर विराट कोहली से 8 इंच ज्यादा चौड़ा है ये देखिए जरा आपके सामने ये जो तुलना है उस पर गौर कीजिए विराट के सीने की चौड़ाई 42 इंच है तो सलमान खान के सीने की चौड़ाई 46 इंच है जबकि मोदी का सीना 56 इंच है। मोदी का सीना 56 इंच है। मोदी का सीना 56 इंच है। मोदी का सीना 56।
That's true. But yeah, it's a slightly serious topic. Being a woman in politics, the challenges are very different than being a man. And I have seen this just by virtue of spectating your Twitter account, Shaina NC's Twitter account, Smriti Irani's Twitter account, Sushma Swaraj's Twitter account. All the leaders, just by virtue of being a woman, that's where you are. The trolling starts there. And that's just sad.
Yeah, it is. And I think it is more here. Of course, it's a problem across the world where any woman leader is judged for what she wears, how she talks, how she smiles, or whether she's had a bad hair day, or whether she's come out, in an angry mood, or someone's done something bad in the house, and that's why she's coming out looking so angry, so stressed, or whatever. So woman is judged a lot more on a regular basis, and she has to. It is a huge challenge for us to keep proving ourselves, our worth, in a sense, or the worth that we bring into the organization, or we can bring perhaps on the table for the country in deciding policies, etc. So it is an ongoing challenge that we face, but it is extremely unfortunate when you face this kind of trolling that happens, where people are not moving beyond what you say, what you do, or how you look, or how you dress.
Priyanka Gandhi star campaigner Congress ki fark aapko lagta hai?
Nahi, us par kya fark lagta hai? Unse zyada to bahut si sundar aur bhi mahilaye ladkiyan hain jo star campaigner hain, heroin hain, kai kalakar hain, wo zyada hain unse zyada.
Are bhai, Priyanka Gandhi ka ki sundarta ka agar wo sundar hain to kya hum keh dein? Ko dusra kuch keh dein?
Now just imagine if nobody opposed anything that I always thought. I would land up not here. Hmm. If nobody disagreed with my plan, I would not be doing what I'm doing right now. I just have to tell you that, because this disagreeing with someone is as important or even more important than agreeing with someone.
And I think it adds value to your argument.
Exactly.
It adds value to your argument. So when you have somebody saying, you coming to me and saying, hey, listen, I think this business idea is brilliant, and I show you the loopholes in that business idea, I don't think I'm reducing your idea. I'm only enhancing it.
Right.
So if you come to me with, hey, this policy is the best thing to happen to the country, but then I remind you that ABC is a problem.
See, but you're right in your example, but there is some gray area here. Because if they even come with a policy sometimes saying this is the policy that we want to implement, and I've seen news debates where there have been Congress senior leaders go like, haan, par Modi ji apni mom se baat nahi karte. That's off point. He's come with a plan. You want to hate that plan? See, that's for politics on debates or in politics or in parliament. They never stick to point. After some time.
I mean, I would love to know any BJP spokesperson who sticks to point and doesn't get into a personal attack mode.
I totally agree, but today I'm sitting with a Congress spokesperson. So I have to
So I think it's more a reaction to what you're listening to, right? So You are constantly bombarded with XYZ personal accusations and personal charge against XYZ leader. So that is, I think that many people who are watching a debate have also learned to ignore.
Exactly. But like, I don't care if my politician is having an extramarital affair. That's his personal life.
Don't even say that. Politicians are not supposed to have that, and they're not supposed to have even a personal life. Right?
They're not even supposed
I know.
But it's funny how they are not even supposed to be seen with a wine glass.
They're not supposed to laugh.
They're not supposed to laugh.
And they're not supposed to be very funny. They're always supposed to be very serious.
Serious and quiet.
Yeah, ask me a serious question next.
So, did Kapil Sibal Kapil Sibal did Rahul Gandhi's homework when he was in school? It's a very serious question.
I would want to know who helped Mr. Modi get his entire political science degree. So if you can give me an answer to that, I'll perhaps answer that question.
Again, we'll disappear for 3 seconds.
So yeah, or if you can give me, and if you can give me perhaps Smriti Irani's Yale degree or whatever, I'll perhaps discuss that with you.
I have family. What's wrong with you? Mom is 62, dad is 65.
I have two kids, okay? Unka bhi dhyan rakho, zara. So no, that's not the point. That was just a joke, by the way. Joke. So, so yes, I've had moments where after a very serious discussion, and which has which has not made sense to perhaps any viewing audience, all right? Because there are like 8 different screens, perhaps 12 that Arnab used to have. And nobody gets a chance to speak and everybody has a point to make. So we're just shouting over each other. None of y'all are perhaps understanding what is being spoken. But y'all are just enjoying how much we are looking irritated, annoyed, laughing or whatever we are doing. And after the discussion, I'm like, either I'm going to pull my hair out or I'm going to, I would perhaps need to go to a shrink to get, you know, stay normal. Because this is not normal.
Yeah,
this
is just not a bad day at work, which all of us go through.
Yeah.
But it's just that your bad day at work, the nation can see. You're having a bad day at work. And
oh, yeah, yeah. So there have been
Priyanka
moments
Priyanka is having a bad day at work.
It all began when Priyanka Chaturvedi began questioning Smriti's security, to which the HRD minister promptly questioned why the interest in her security. And from there, the fight quickly descended into political mudslinging. Smriti Irani says, why are you so interested in my security? Planning something? To which Priyanka Chaturvedi says, not worth my time, so don't worry on that front. You must concentrate on creating another campus ruckus. Smriti Irani then responds, saying, that's more Rahul Ji's forte, or wait, losing a Sam is. My bad, have a good day. Priyanka Chaturvedi then responds by saying, repeatedly losing and yet becoming a minister in the cabinet is your forte. You have a glorious day too.
Yeah, and you get instant comments on Twitter, right? So you get instant feedback. Why are you screeching like a lunatic? And I like your sari, but I thought you were making horrible, points out there.
Then you should put down where you bought the sari from. This is from Nalli. Go to this outlet.
I wish they'd sponsor.
Then it's easy to brand plug in.
No, so I did that once. I just very casually I mentioned I love Sabyasachi sarees, right? And someone said, you are paid for that tweet. This is a sponsored tweet coming from Sabyasachi. Manika, like, Sabyasachi needs me to sponsor, talk about his sarees. His work speaks for itself. Why should I be? Yeah. I'm not going to talk about any.
And Modi on front page with Reliance Jio is not an endorsement. Tweeting Sabyasachi sarees.
जब तक जियो मौज करो जियो हां जब तक जियो मौज करो
बढ़िया मैन आई वांट टू गो ऑन अर्नब शो वंस
यू मस्ट इट्स क्वाइट एन एक्सपीरियंस
बिकॉज़ फॉर द फर्स्ट हाफ एन आई वांट टू एग्री विद एवरीथिंग अर्नब सेज लाइक फर्स्ट हाफ एन आवर व्हाटएवर ही सेज इंडियाज बेस्ट आई विल बी लाइक या जस्ट बैंग माय चेस्ट विद for half an hour, and then when he comes to me, so Kunal, what do you have to say? Then I'll disagree with him. Then I'll be like, you're a bloody idiot. That's what I have to say.
Yeah, calm down, you. You're, what is the question? Calming down. You utter all the stupidity.
Sir, you see.
And I'm supposed to keep calm. What are you talking
sir,
about? I'm
I'll
shocked.
Tell you.
Don't
because,
be stupid.
Because you no, I'm not
don't
being stupid.
Be stupid.
I'm not being stupid.
Don't be stupid. I'm why? Don't be stupid.
Right now. Now coming back to this topic, Arnab, anyone.
But coming to a very important question, which you guys have been accused for most, which is, y'all handled.
What are we not accused for?
My dad, water ran out. He started abusing the Congress party. I reminded him, BJP is in power. It happens. So you're right. Accusations never end.
Which is okay. That means expectations of the people are also sky high for us. So it's okay. So they give these temporary breaks to us and then they bring us back.
You guys, see, you're trying very hard to find a silver lining.
No, there is. You know, it is like Mr. Narendra Modi yesterday came and announced, women do not have to change their names on their passports after marriage. It always was in place.
It was.
So it's
they
about
all are just not highlighting the things.
No, perhaps you're not reading the right things. I would say.
No, on the internet, these are the right things to read.
Because that is
like
the only.
If India does.
Because right is the only thing that you are reading.
Right. I agree with you. But I'll tell you, if India achieves something like the surgical strike, right? Happens, whole country proud, this and that. First article that came out of there saying, Modi ji ne last 6 ghanta pani nahi piya. You know what I mean? Like, how is this news relevant to me? But I have to read it.
Pradhanmantri Modi ne raat bhar rakhi operation par nazar. Raat bhar jaage Modi ne pani ka ghoont nahi piya.
Because this is what it is. Like, this is the news that people are sharing. It'll appear on my timeline 4 times. I will read it. at some point. I'm intelligent enough to see through it. But if it appears 5 times on your timeline, what choice do you have?
No, you'd all, if you are smart enough, you'd say, "Tum mujhe kya usse lena dena, mujhe lena dena wo surgical strike se hai." So the point is, you can keep highlighting these things and you can keep looking at this as a success story, like you just mentioned Yogi Adityanath's private medical college bit, which was already in place. It is like saying that, I gave you the passport instance where Narendra Modi ji yesterday, it just
but
happened.
But again, just then can Congress accept that BJP is better campaigners? Let's not discuss.
We have acknowledged that there's not a better PR person than Narendra Modi. Even if he's not doing anything, but 6 hours unne vrat rakha.
This is that Congress party.
So you better acknowledge it.
This country is driven on content. Like, anyway. Kabhi-kabhi lagta hai wo dad ne jo golf ka job bola tha le lena chahiye. But on some days, not on most days. On other days, India's best.
ये मेरा इंडिया, ये मेरा इंडिया, I love my India.
You know, some Congress leader like Shashi Tharoor is the only guy who shed such light on JNU and other issues of dissent that have come across in the last 1.5 years. But the problem is that nobody here gets the accent. India, finally, if you don't start a speech with Mitro, you're not connecting with people. People are just like, "Kaun baat kar raha hai yaar? Isne start bhi nahi kiya theek se."
Congress ke Mitro, aap is baat se sehmat hai? Aap sehmat hai, bhai? Aap sehmat hai?
I have just last question, because that's been the debate for the last 3 years from the time the BJP has come into power till now. What's your definition of patriotism?
Aap gana koi bhi gaiye. गाना समाप्त होगा वंदे मातरम के ऊपर. आप देखिए देखिए,
मैं झंडू बाम हुई डार्लिंग तेरे लिए, मुझी बदनाम हुई डार्लिंग तेरे लिए,
सारे मापनी
it feels good to be a gangster. And where is the line that should not be crossed?
For me, it's about live and let live.
Right.
It is about, you know, I'm a pure vegetarian. I don't even have eggs. But I'm absolutely okay with you bringing any kind of food inside my house and eating what you want. I will have no problem with that. I respect your space. You respect mine.
And don't you ever try to cross the line.
The only way to be patriotic towards your country is to question the people who pretend to be stakeholders of it. And nothing else.
If
tomorrow you're in power,
you'll have to drop those pretensions, let me tell
you
that.
No, but
if we are in power, we are not going to be asking you for your patriotism certificate every day.
Jo Madhur Bhandarkar ji aaj हर जगह जाकर प्रेस ले रहे हैं, मुंबई में लेने की कोशिश किए, पुणे में लेने की कोशिश किए, कांग्रेसी नेताओं का यही कहना है कि उन्होंने यह फिल्म उन पहले कांग्रेस के कुछ नेताओं को दिखाए सिलेक्टेड, अगर उसमें कुछ आपत्तिजनक नहीं है तो हमें कोई ऐतराज नहीं है, मगर उसमें कुछ आपत्तिजनक चित्र है तो हम कहेंगे कि ये फिल्म नहीं दिखाई जाए, क्योंकि इंदिरा जी गांधी जो एक महान नेता थी, कुछ उनके बारे में कुछ अलग बताने की कोशिश किसी से सुपारी लेकर मधुकर भांडारकर कर रहा होगा तो मुझे लगता है कि इस मधुर भांडारकर को इस नागपुर में नहीं, देश के कोई भी कोने में जाएगा तो कांग्रेसी लोग जूते ही मारने वाले.
बट देयर इज वन थिंग ऑन द यूपी इलेक्शंस दैट वी डिडंट डिस्कस टोटली, व्हिच वाज ऑफ कोर्स यू पॉइंटेड आउट दैट द कैंडिडेट्स वर नॉट मेंशन दैट दिस गाय विल बी योर सीएम, यू आर वोटिंग फॉर हिम, देयर वाज नो डायरेक्ट पैटर्न टू व्हाटएवर, व्हिच इज टोटली आई गेट. But then after that, I saw people in Bombay and other metro cities on these dinner tables just going like, BJP, the mask is off, and this is a total saffron-led this and... And I was just like, from my house in Shivaji Park, I saw a poster in 2014 which had Narendra Modi on it and it said, I'm a Hindu contesting for Prime Minister. There was no mask. Why are people saying the mask is off? You know what I mean? Like, I would be surprised if Yogi Adityanath was not the chosen candidate. Not, I'm not surprised that he is, because they've been on point. Like, here's what we're here to do, here's what we will do, and we will do it. So at least they are not like, on the internet we can just keep on saying whatever, whatever, whatever. But they've just been clear, they campaigned with this idea, and they will push it forward.
See, Mr. Modi, for whatever, you know, keep, if we keep that 2002 aside and post that image makeover post 2002.
I have, one of my friend's father has this theory. There are two candidates from the BJP who will be neck to neck in 2024 elections. One of them is Yogi Adityanath. And second is Baba Ramdev. And I am telling you, if that happens, Baba Ramdev could very well. He's got everything. Yeah, yeah. Fucking Patanjali products.
ये तो एकदम जबरदस्त निकाला है. इसको लगाने से ना चेहरा ऐसा हो जाता है जैसे सोना. ये स्वर्ण कांति गोल्ड क्रीम है. पहले 10,000 रुपए का बेचता था, 10,000 रुपए का, और हमने ये दे दिया खाली 399 रुपए का.
खोल कर दिखाइए ना इन लोगों को.
ये देखो इतना जोरदार है. ये आपके चेहरे पर लगाता हूँ ना.
देखिए बाबा जी के चेहरे पर लगा रहे हैं ये क्रीम.
ये देखो
चश्मा हटा था, लगाइए.
ये देखो, ये सोने जैसा चमकने लगे. देखो आप लोग, ये देखो सच्ची में, ये देखो गोल्ड जैसा. देखो ये गोल्ड क्रीम है लालू जी, देखने में सफेद है, जब लगता है ना. देखो आपका लालू का गालू तो ऐसे भी बड़ा लालू है, लालू का गालू तो ऐसे भी बड़ा लालू है.
Yeah, he's the next Donald Trump, perhaps. Not Mr. Modi.
But yeah. I think this is this has been a great chat, and it's a good end to our podcast. So let's thank Priyanka Chaturvedi for joining us.
Thank you so much.
And that's the end of the podcast. Thank you so much for watching. You know, if you guys have something to say in the comment section.
Hey, shut up, ya Kunal.
Shut up, ya Kunal.
If you had to choose to be a spokesperson right now of any other party, but at gunpoint, there is no choice.
No.
No, actually, that's a wrong question because it's too real. Editor! Dear editor, please do some work on this.
लॉजिक के बदले में सोचा मिलता है, वो खोरे जो उसको ऑरेंज लड्डू मिलता है. यही देश नहीं जो मुल्क की रेस है, इसमें सच ने किया क्या कैमोफ्लेज फेस है. देखो मैंने अब सवाल करने छोड़ दिए हैं, मैंने तेज भागने को नए जूते लिए हैं, मेरे सारे सपने धीरे धीरे मर रहे हैं.
सियाचिन में हमारे जवान लड़ रहे हैं.